Horse chestnut. That's funnily enough what I call Nighthorn's genitals. The horse chestnut.
Say it or shot it.
Hello, I'm Harriet Rose, and this is Say It or Shot It with Lewis Capaldi.
Woo! Oh, I thought we were all going to.
Thought we're all going to join in on that
one.
No
way.
Okay, go again, and I'll do it.
Right.
Say It or Shot It with Lewis Capaldi. Woo!
That's bad. Let's play the game.
Question number one. Can you tell us a secret, Lewis Capaldi, about Niall Horan?
I can give you his address.
Well, okay, cool. Just quickly get a pen. Then I've got a pen.
I'd say, people probably don't know, he's blessed.
Blessed?
He's blessed.
By? Oh.
Blessed.
By?
An inches.
Oh!
That's probably not what you want to hear, but it's true.
How do you know I don't want to hear that?
How do you know I don't want to hear that? No, oh, sorry. I thought you were asking me how I know, and then how I know.
Well, how do you know? Good question, Lewis.
Seen it. I'm on with these. See these things.
Seen it in your real life eyes.
Yeah, seen it in my real life. I've not seen a picture of it. That'd be a scoop. But no, I've seen it.
Well, you did tell me earlier that you sent unsolicited pictures to Harry Styles.
Yeah, but I think that's out of context. That sounds bad. I don't know what it was. I don't think it was anything. The only nude picture I've ever taken myself is when I was trying to take a picture of my hemorrhoids.
And how did that go?
I got them.
Did you?
I've got them. I got a colonic irrigation the other day.
Did you?
Yeah. It's great. I would highly recommend it. Yeah, yeah.
I don't know how you've managed to go from seeing Niall Horan's genitals.
Well, I never said anything. I never said anything about genitals. You've put
that there. That was me putting two and five together.
Yeah.
And then you sent something to Harry Styles that we don't know what it was, could be something unsolicited. Then to you taking naked pictures of yourself. Then to hemorrhoids, then to having a colonic irrigation.
It's a roller coaster. And that's what happens right here on Kiss FM.
Sorry, back to the colonic irrigation.
Yes.
How's your bum feeling now?
I feel great. I do have hemorrhoids still.
I tell you what you can take for those. There is actually a thing called horse chestnut.
Horse chestnut?
Well, I wish your hemorrhoids the best.
And that's funnily enough what I call Nighthorn's genitals. The horse chestnut.
Well, you have revealed quite substantial amount of information.
I hope he's okay
with
me saying that. I'll have to text him after and see if that's okay.
It's too late.
Yeah.
Right, my go.
Your question. Have you been caught doing something you shouldn't have? If so, what?
Yes. I've got a good one for this.
Okay.
At a festival, I was pants down having a wee down the side of a dance tent. And I got caught. It was one of those festivals where they were like, don't pee on the floor because it goes into the rivers and then everyone's going to die or something.
Yeah, three pretty big steps there that they've taken.
And a woman came round, a security guard, and she went, dirty, no!
Oh, no.
And I was like, no. And I carried on weeing.
Yeah.
And I pulled up my pants and I said, that wasn't what you thought it was.
Yeah, yeah. Wait, what?
I lied to the woman.
Oh, right, okay. Right, I see. I thought, never mind. It's, yeah. Okay, cool.
Okay. What is the strangest rumour you've heard about yourself?
That my genitals are just so huge. I was like, what? That's so crazy.
False rumours?
That's not the rumour. No one said that about me ever, trust me. The strangest rumour I've ever heard was that I have a comedy writer. It was going to be in the paper initially, and I was like, well, it's not true. I mean, so it doesn't happen.
But also, did the paper come to you and go, hey, we're about to break this breaking story about you having a comedy writer?
Yeah, yeah, and you have to go, yeah, it's not true. If I did, that would be much more funny than that.
It's very impressive for people to think that you have someone writing your jokes for you.
But I wouldn't say I have jokes. I don't have, like, anyway, so this was... this.
I hate that kind of comedy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. My mother-in-law is dead.
I would...
You know what I mean? I don't have a mother-in-law.
But she is dead, yeah.
What paid partnership product have you got that you don't use? Well, that's well good, that, by the way.
Okay, then.
That's so good.
There's no way I can answer that question because honey needs the money.
Yeah, yeah. You got to get... Don't fumble the bag. Take the shot.
I'm going to let Lewis Capaldi pick my shot.
I'm not letting you pick mine.
I'm going to, but yeah, go on.
I want you to drink that
one. I knew you were going to say that. You nasty piece of work.
It's the thickness of it.
Cheers to you.
Cheers.
Horrible person.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. There's the thumbnail.
Oh, here's a good one. Do you have 1 million in the bank?
Yeah. Next question.
Can I have some money?
Sure. Much.
How much would you give me? How much have you got in your wallet?
I don't have. Hey, let me check. I don't really carry cash.
Classic. 1 million in the bank doesn't carry cash.
I don't have any.
Oh,
cash.
You've got one of those. Oh.
Just cards.
Okay, I'll settle for you buying me something.
Yeah. Okay.
But yeah, I'll leave that to you.
There you go. That's lovely.
Your turn.
What's the biggest misconception about you?
That I'm nice.
Yeah. I can vouch she is a horrible person.
A horrible person. No, I don't know what the biggest misconception of me is.
It's more a question for other people.
Okay, so what, did you know anything about me before you came here?
I know your name and you did radio.
Okay.
I've heard you on the radio before.
Okay. Did you have any misconceptions about me? What did you think about me when you saw me?
Yeah, I thought you'd be taller.
Wow. Okay. Well, I'm actually 5'5½", Lewis, so...
So, yeah. I thought you'd be 5'6". What's your biggest misconception about me?
That you had a big...
Yeah.
Big, yeah. That was my biggest.
I don't know how you found that out, but...
Well, you told me about five times.
Yeah, I did, yeah. You just rewind it.
Should I do a shot because I didn't have a misconception? You're not picking it again.
Oh, right, no.
You nasty piece of work. Sorry. Or shall I let him pick it? Oh, go on then. It's the red one, isn't it?
No, I want you to do the one that kind of looks like little.
No, because you're just testing the ones you don't want to do. So to see my reaction. Fine. That wasn't what I expected.
Is it like pulpy?
I'm not telling you anything. It was quite nice, actually.
Oh, really?
Oh, here we go. Have you ever dated a celebrity in secret? If so, who?
No.
Oh, for God's sake, Lewis.
That's the thing. I really thought that I was going to be able to date celebrities, and I was like, oh, I can't wait to, like, you know.
If you were going to date a celebrity, who would it be? And don't say Niall Horan.
No, I'll think. I don't know, someone who's got, like, nice energy. Who looks calm.
Calm?
Who's, like, nice and chilled. Who will stay in and put their feet up with me.
Okay. I can't think of anyone.
Davina McCall.
Oh, she's my icon. She's my star.
I love Davina McCall.
Okay, Lewis Capaldi and Davina McCall. I can really see that happening.
Yeah, okay.
My go.
Yes, okay.
Please.
Let's get going. Rate these singers from best to worst. Ray, Griff, or Jade Thirlwell.
You know I'm not going to do that.
It's good that you're like, because you like work and you might see these people more than I will.
Right, Lewis, quickly pick me a shot.
Black one.
You absolute...
Oh, sorry, I didn't get it on my shoes.
Don't get it on my shoes. I just nearly shotted a pint of soy sauce. Soy sauce.
Yeah.
My mouth is going to be soy sauce all day.
You've got a little bit on your face.
Get it off then. That's actually very romantic.
Thank you.
Okay, what is the worst song you've heard this year? That is a good
That's
one.
That's a great question, and I've got plenty of answers. Let me just think. The thing is, I don't want to be nasty to someone for the sake of, like...
Take a shot, then.
Yeah, I will.
Yay! Okay, you have to take that one.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, wait, we do one what we haven't done. This one.
All right. Oh, it's quite spicy, that. Like sriracha. The aftertaste of that is worse than the actual thing. Can it taste like?
Your own skull.
Like bad breath.
Oh!
But you're not going to answer this. Who do you prefer, Jordan or Perry from Kiss Bradford?
Yeah, it depends. Jordan.
Really? Why?
Because I bully Perry, so it's easier to say Jordan.
Right, okay, I see. Bit of a cop out, but.
Yeah. No, I think that's fair.
Well, no, because then it's like, oh, we're all friends. I want, you know, real.
I like Jordan's naughty sense of humour and Perry's dress sense.
Perry, he's a good-looking guy. Cool-looking
Not to say Jordan doesn't have a good dress sense,
well,
Lewis.
Well, you said it.
Final one for you.
Yeah, let's do it.
Snog, marry, avoid.
Great.
H. Mm-hmm. Elton John.
Mm-hmm.
Stormzy.
Oh, good stuff, that, by the way. Elton's in a happy marriage, so I'd avoid him. Because I don't want to be a homewrecker.
That's very noble of you.
Thank you.
Also, because you know you haven't got a chance.
It's true. It's very true. Then, Kiss H.
I think H would be a good kisser.
Yeah, Kiss H.
Do you know if H is a good kisser?
I haven't had the luxury.
Well.
I've found that out yet. Yeah, as he says. and then I marry Stormzy because he's such a warm, sort of like...
Lovely chap.
And he's loaded, so he'd take good care of me. Oh, this is good. Do you fancy me?
Yeah.
Nice.
Didn't even hesitate.
Shall we just do the I'll just do them all.
Oh, well, I'm going to have to now.
Yeah.
Okay,
nice
cheers
one.
Then.
Yeah, that's Iron Brew for sure.
I know.
I don't like the bits in that. It's limoncello or something like that.
Lemon.
I don't like that. Too lemon. Oh, mixed face. I'll do that one last.
Oh, no. Let me do hot and you do creamy at the same time. Hot and creamy. Louis Capaldi.
Ooh.
That's nice. Oh!
I can't do thickness. I like it. There's no napkin.
Don't drink it. No, don't drink it. Oh, you did. Lads. Finish it off with a nice bit of Iron Brew, sweetie. How's that bit at the end? That was nice. Do you like it? Oh, yeah. Lewis Capaldi, Harriet Rose, say it or shot it. I would say completed it.
Yeah, I feel a bit ill. I think it's more the, that will catch up with you in a little bit, I think.
Yeah, I'll take that with me to where I go next.
It's heating up my tummy. I've got a hot tummy.
You do have a hot tummy.
Thanks very much. Cheers.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it. Kiss. The beat of the UK. Kiss.